हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक। आई एम अनामिका, योर बायो टीचर, विद अ न्यू चैप्टर, माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स फ्रेंड एंड फो। माइक्रो दैट मीन्स वेरी स्मॉल इन साइज। आई थिंक यू हैव रीड अबाउट द इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो, बट लेट्स रिकैप इट। सो माइक्रो दैट मीन्स वेरी स्मॉल इन साइज, मैक्रो विच आर लार्ज इन साइज। सो वॉट आर द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स? द ऑर्गेनिजम्स विच आर वेरी स्मॉल इन साइज and can't be observed by our naked eye, and they can be observed only under microscope. Microscope, that is an instrument which is used to magnify any small object, and those organisms are called microorganisms. Example, bacteria, viruses, algae, etc. Next is, what is microbiology? The branch of science which deals with the study of the microorganisms, that is called microbiology. And the person, those who study about the microorganisms, they are called microbiologist. Microscope, right now I told you that an instrument which is uses a combination of lenses to make a small objects appear bigger. Next is types of microscope. Microscopes generally of three types: simple, compound and electron microscope. Among these, the highest magnification is of electron microscope, which is generally used to see the smallest, like the cell organelles also, which is present in the cell. Compound microscope, that is generally used in the science lab to observe any specimen. Next are the features of the microorganisms, that means they are present everywhere. You can say they are omnipresent. They are present in desert, polar areas, in spring also, in air, in water also, land, inside and outside the body of the organisms, in food items also. They are differ in sizes and they are generally measured in the microns. They are unicellular as well as multicellular. Some are useful and some are harmful for us. Next is the group of microorganisms. The five groups are there: bacteria, viruses, algae, fungi and protozoa. One by one we will read about that. So first is bacteria. Bacteria, that is the first living organisms on the earth surface. You can say that is the oldest life form. Actually, around 4.5 billion years ago, the earth was too hot, just like a, you can say, the huge ball of fire. Gradually, around 3.5 billion years ago, it little bit cool. And in that condition, the water can also exist in the droplet form. Some compounds are also formed. So gradually, after that, first organisms that appears on the earth surface, that was the archaea. And you can say that is the ancestor of the bacteria. So bacteria originates from the archaea. And who observed or saw the bacteria first of all? That was Anton von Leeuwenhoek, who saw the bacteria while he was doing some experiment with the pond water. Next is bacteria, that is unicellular organisms. Unicellular, that means it is made up of single cell, and the cell is prokaryotic. What is prokaryotic? That means nucleus is not well developed. That means nucleus is not surrounded by nuclear membrane. They can present everywhere. Right now I told you, example, in soil, water, radioactive waste, deep portion of the earth crust, in ponds, animals' bodies, etc. They live in colonies. Colonies, that means they live in group. See the diagram of the bacteria, a typical bacterial cell. It is the outermost covering, that is called capsule or capsid. Inside that, this is the two layer. The outer one is cell wall, which is made up of peptidoglion. The inner one is cell membrane. And this is the cytoplasm. Inside the cytoplasm, nucleoid is present. Nucleus is nothing, just the nuclear matter, you can say the nucleoplasm, which is not surrounded by the nuclear membrane. And inside the nucleoid, circular DNA is present. That is a genetic material of the bacteria. Ribosomes are also present. This is the flagella. Single one is called flagellum, which helps in the movement. And this is the hair-like structure, that is called pilus, or the larger one is called fimbriae, which helps in the conjugation process. Conjugation, that means attaching one bacteria to the other bacteria. Next is shape and size. They vary in shape and size. On the basis of shape, bacteria are of four types. Rod-shaped bacteria, that is called bacillus, and plural is called bacilli. Example is lactobacillus. I think you are familiar about the term lactobacillus, which is present in curd. This is like this. And all of you know that curd, that is very good for health. Why? Because it contains probiotic, which is good for our health. Next is a spherical shaped bacteria, that is called coccus or cocci. Plural is cocci. This is diplococcus. This is, when it is in chain, it is called a streptococcus. When it is in group, that is called a staphylococcus. Example, a streptococcus pneumonia, which causes pneumonia. A spiral or curve shaped, that is a spirillum. Example is a spirulina. Next is the, or a spirochetes. Coma shaped bacteria, that is vibrios. Example is Vibrio cholera, which causes cholera disease. Next is size. Bacteria size then generally varies from 0.2 to 5 micrometer. A smallest bacteria, that is Mycoplasma, which is known as PPLO, that means pleuropneumonia like organisms, which diameter is 200 to 300 nanometer. Largest bacteria is Spirochetes, which belongs to the spiral or curve shape, that is about 500 micrometer in length. Next, see the nutrition. On the basis of mode of nutrition, bacteria are generally of following types: autotrophs, which can prepare their own food. Example is cyanobacteria. Saprophytic, which depends on dead and decay matter. Parasitic, which lives inside the host. Some bacteria are aerobic. Aerobic means, that means they break down the food in the presence of oxygen, and some are anaerobic, which can break down the food in the absence of oxygen. Growth and reproduction. During favorable condition, bacteria multiply very fast. Example, E. coli. They are present in intestine and can take about 20 minutes to reproduce. That means one bacteria can double in 20 minutes. They generally reproduce by binary fission, which is also a method of asexual reproduction. During unfavorable condition, some bacteria form a spores or cyst, that means the hard covering and breast insides, and when favorable condition come, they grow and multiply. Next is the useful bacteria. So that means all bacteria are not harmful, some are useful for also. So let's see that how they help us. So some bacteria are useful for making dairy products like cheese, curds, in the preparation of curd. Lactobacillus are used. Right now I told you about that. They are also used in the preparation of antibiotics. Antibiotics are generally medicines which is used for killing the microorganisms to improve the immunity of the body. Some bacteria are decomposer, which helps in the decomposition of dead and decay matter, and in this way they helps in cleaning the environment. Some good bacteria are lives in the intestine of humans and helps in the digestion of food and killing bad bacteria. And they can also stop the growth of the uncontrolled cell, which can cause cancer also. Some bacteria helps in the nitrogen fixation, like rhizobium, azobacter. Some bacteria are used in the processing of leather, in tanning process, in the processing of, you can say, fiber also in jute industry. But not all the bacteria are useful. Some are harmful also. Some bacteria are harmful and causes various diseases in animals and in plants also, in humans. In humans, it causes typhoid, cholera, etc. In plants, citrus canker. Some bacteria are responsible for spoiling the food, like milk, fruits, vegetables, cooked food also. They produce toxic substances. If anyone consumes spoiled food items, they may suffer from the food poisoning, and sometimes food poisoning even may cause death of the person. The symptoms are vomiting, diarrhea, stomach ache. So these are the symptoms of the food poisoning. Example is Clostridium botulinum, which causes food poisoning. So that's all. In our next video, we will read about the viruses. Thank you, students.